Dijkstra's algorithm. Dijkstra's algorithm is used to calculate the minimum distance from the source to destination. It is also called as single pair shortest path algorithm. In a Dijkstra's algorithm, usually the source node will be mentioned and it is always a directed graph. Let us consider one example. Here we have five nodes A, B, C, D and E. They are connected by a directed graph and these numbers represent the cost. To solve this in Dijkstra's algorithm, we construct a table. The first column contains free vertex. The second column, remaining vertex. Under remaining vertex, it is subdivided into the number of nodes. Here we have five nodes. So we name them as A, B, C, D, and E. So here, as said before, it is from source to destination. The source is mentioned as A. So A will be 0 and the remaining nodes will be at infinity. Since A is our source, you should trace from A which are the nodes connected. So A dash comma dash. So from A you cannot connect to A. From A to B there is no connection. A to C no connection. A to E no connection. Only D is connected directly. So first fill up D. So D element can be accessed through A at a rate of 7. Usually the element which is on the node name which is on top is given outside the bracket and the following column node is mentioned inside. For now fill up the remaining three. So B can be accessed through A at a rate of infinity. C can be accessed through A at a rate of infinity. E can be accessed through A at a rate of infinity. Now when we compare these four nodes, only 7 is lesser when compared to infinity. So now we can access node 7, A comma 7. From A, D, you cannot connect to A, so dash. From D to D, they cannot be connected, so D is also dash. From D to C, you have a connection. From D to C, you have connection. D to E also, there is a connection. So from D to B, the first connection. So from D through, from B through D, you can access it at a rate of 7 plus 2. 7 is from A to D, from D to B is 2. So B, D, 9. The same way for C. C can be accessed through D at a rate of A to D is 7 plus D to C is 5, which will be 12. So now similar for E. So you can access E through D by A to D will be 7 plus D to E will be 4. D comma 11. So now when we compare these three nodes, take the least one. Here 9 has the least value. So take B of D comma 9. So now A cannot be accessed, B cannot be accessed, D cannot be accessed. Only C and E. Here there is a when you want to access C from A, D, B. So A to D will be 7. B to D is 2 plus B to C is 4. This will give us 13. 13 is greater when compared to 12. We have to find the minimum path. So you don't take this C, B, 13. You go with the previous lesser value C of D, 12. So this B of 13 cannot take place. So you go with C of D, 12. And to reach E through A, B, D. Since C node is not been accessed so far, you cannot reach E. So the same value comes down. Now when we compare these two nodes, it is found that E is to be lesser, 11 is lesser. So it will be the next accessed node. So A to A, E to A no connection, B to E no connection, E to D no connection, E to E no connection. Now from E to C, there is no connection. So you bring down C of D, 12. Now the last element, only one node is there, C of D, 12. You cannot access it through A, B, D, E. You cannot access the same element, so it is becomes dash. So now we've reached the final step when no other node can be accessed. Now to frame the table. The table can be framed by using three columns. Source, destination, and cost. So our source node is A. From A we must access B, C, D and E. From A to B, B is accessed at a rate of 9 here. From A to C, C is accessed at a rate of 12. From A to D, it is accessed at a rate of 7. From A to E, it is accessed at a rate of 11. This is how a DigiCross algorithm can be resolved.